So, I've got 20 chairs up here. It didn't sound like I'm going to fill all of them. I do have some simple rules to go over before we start the show. First rule I'm going to throw away. First rule is always, you must be at least 14 years of age or older. You're going to get a chance to come up here and volunteer tonight. You're not 14, are you? You are 14? Oh. Alright. We're throwing that away. You don't have to be 14. We just fill up the chairs tonight. But second rule is the most important rule for me, and that is this. Don't come up here and try to prove to me you can't be hypnotized. Hypnosis is not something I do to you, it's something we do together. I like to tell people, it's like we're riding in a car. You're driving the car, I'm the guy in the passenger seat with a map. As long as you do exactly what I tell you to do, when I tell you to do it, we won't have any problems. But any time I told you to turn left and you went right, we'd never get to go where we need to go. So don't come up here and try to prove to me that you can't be hypnotized. I can't hypnotize anybody against their will. So, you do want to volunteer, but you're thinking, I don't know about this. I think he's going to humiliate me once I get up there. I'm not going to humiliate anybody. We're going to have some fun. If you saw the show last year, you can testify to the fact that I don't humiliate anybody. We just play around with your subconscious mind, get you really creative, and let you have some fun. Also, if you do volunteer, 1 hour of hypnosis is like 8 hours of sleep. You're going to leave here feeling awesome tonight. Also, if you volunteer and I keep you all the way to the end of the show, I give you some positive suggestions. So if there's anything you'd like to want to change, if you want to quit smoking, lose weight, do better at school, anything at all, I'll give you some positive suggestions while you're up here. It's just my way of saying thank you for allowing me to do the show. So, if you want to volunteer, come on down. I don't force anybody to come up, so come on up, fill up these chairs, best that we can, and let's have some fun. So, looking at this group right here, probably going to lose a few of you, but high school students are usually the best volunteers. From high school right up to about 25, 26 years old, highly suggestible, highly hypnotizable, and a lot of fun. The adults, it starts to taper off a little bit, and I lose a couple of them, but we're going to do the best that we can. So we're all set. All right. Let's hear it for our volunteers. Give them a big round of applause. I do want to thank you guys for volunteering too. Without you guys, I can't do a show. It would have been really awkward for me to just stand up here for an hour. So, starting right now, you guys are the stars of the show. I don't sing, I don't dance, I don't tell jokes. You guys are the stars. In order to remain the star of the show, I need you to stay in your chairs at all times. Under no circumstance should you leave your chairs and return to the audience. Because sometimes people get hypnotized, they don't realize it, they end up back out there doing all the crazy things, and those guys can see much better if you stay up here. Also, I may have told this story last year, but I do a lot of post-prom shows, and I was in Cortland a couple of years ago. I used to have 40 kids up on stage at post-prom shows, and I decided that night that was too many because the girl got hypnotized, didn't realize it, she left the stage on her own. She spent the next 45 minutes crawling back up to the stage, acting really weird. They thought she had been drinking at the prom, so they yanked her off the stage. They were going to call her parents. They just asked me to please go talk to her. So I walked in and said, do me a favor, look right here. And sleep. She fell face first right out of her chair. She was still hypnotized. So please remain in your chair so I can keep you safe at all times. Also, if I do dismiss you, as I said, it doesn't mean you can't be hypnotized. It just means for whatever reason, tonight was not the night for you. You couldn't focus and concentrate. So if I do dismiss you, it doesn't mean you can't be. That 10% of people that I said can't be, it's just for that given night. Everybody can be hypnotized. You see, in life, you're either awake or asleep or someplace in between. Hypnosis is that place in between. So you've all been hypnotized. I'll give you a couple of examples that you might be familiar with. You ever been riding in your car? You suddenly realize you can't remember what happened those last 2 miles. It's completely gone from your mind. You can't remember if you stopped at the stop sign, the stoplight was red or green. That's highway hypnosis. If you've ever been in a movie, sad movie, and you started crying, that's hypnosis. If you've ever been in a room full of other people, somebody yawns and you start yawning, that's hypnosis. So everybody has been hypnotized at some point. So please remain in your chairs. If I do dismiss you, I may just shake your hand, I may point at you, point at the audience, kick you in the butt. If I don't do any of those things, stay in your chairs. You guys out in the audience, in just a moment, if you've never seen a hypnosis show before, what's going to happen is I'm going to guide them through some relaxation techniques. They're going to have their arms in different positions, they'll be slumped over in their chairs, they'll be leaning on one another. It's going to look really funny if you've never seen a show before. That's the induction. That's the part where I need you to remain as quiet as possible. So can everybody please silence your cell phones? If you can remain quiet during that part, I can get them to focus and concentrate on me, and I can get them into a good state of hypnosis. If you guys have your cell phones, go ahead and silence them. Does anybody have any questions before we start? Is anybody chewing any gum? Just grab a quick drink. the advantages of a small audience. This is going to be really quiet, so you guys should be able to focus and concentrate really good. So we're going to start. I do my induction in three stages. The first stage is just following my instructions. So what I'd like you all to do is restrict your chairs, feet flat on the floor, hands, palms down, one on each leg. And just focus right here on me. Don't take your eyes off my hand until I tell you to do so. I'm going to take three deep breaths in. Deep breaths are just to help you relax. So everybody take a nice deep breath in, filling up your lungs. And exhale all the way out. And again, the second breath, really deep breath in, filling up your lungs. And exhale again, all the way out. And the third one is your deepest breath in, really, really filling up your lungs. And this time as you exhale, just close your eyes down. So I said, this first step is just following my instructions. So what I'd like you all to do right now is just make a conscious decision to forget about everybody that's up here on the stage with you, and forget about everybody that's out in the audience. I want you to focus only on the sound of my voice. Any other sounds you hear, it's just the sounds of everyday life going on around you, letting you know you're safe and secure, which gives you permission to just relax and enjoy the experience. I also want you to think only about relaxation. Any other thoughts that come into your mind, just let them float right back out just as easily as they floated in. I can't ask you to stop thinking, that would be impossible. I'm just asking you to not hold on to those thoughts when they come in. So any other thoughts that come into your mind, just let them float right back out. Think to yourself, relax. Return your attention to the sound of my voice and allow yourself to go even deeper relaxed. Now in just a moment, I'm going to count from 1 up to 3. When I get to 3, I want you to open your eyes and focus right back here on me again. 1, 2, and 3. Eyes open. That's what hypnosis is going to feel like. A lot of times people think this can't be working, I don't feel hypnotized. Hypnosis is not a feeling, it's a state of mind. You'll never feel hypnotized. Like I said, you'll be a little bit more relaxed, maybe leaning on one another, but you're never going to feel hypnotized. You'll also be able to hear my voice at all times. The other thing I get is I don't think I'm hypnotized, I can still hear you. You need to hear me because I'm giving you suggestions, so you need to follow my suggestions, so you'll always hear me. So we're going to move on to step 2. Step 2 is a test of your imagination. So what I'd like everyone to do is hold your right arm straight out in front of you, palm up. Left arm straight out in front of you, palm down. Perfect. Keep your arms just like that. And just go ahead and close your eyes down. And again, just focus on the sound of my voice. We're going to do those 3 deep breaths again. Let's do them together. First breath, really deep breath into your lungs, filling up your lungs. And exhale. Again, the second breath deeper than the first, really filling up your lungs. And exhale again, feeling even better. And again, the third breath is the deepest breath in, so really filling up your lungs. And exhale all the way out. Step 2, as I said, is a test of your imagination. So what I'd like you to do right now, keeping your eyes closed, I want you to just imagine you can see through your eyelids. Imagine you can see me standing right in front of you. In my right hand, I'm holding a bucket. This can be a bucket of any color because in just a moment, it's going to be your bucket. I want you to imagine now you can see me walking up, and I'm placing the handle to that bucket across the palm of your right hand. I want you to close your fingers tightly around that bucket handle and don't let go. I want you to now imagine you can see me walking up, and I'm placing the end of a garden hose into your bucket. Going to the other end of that garden hose, and I'm turning on the water. Imagine that water flowing through the garden hose and into your bucket. I want you to imagine you can see that water. Imagine you can hear that water. Imagine you can feel that bucket now getting heavier and heavier and heavier. As that water continues to fill that bucket, your right arm will get more and more tired, being drawn closer and closer to the ground. I don't want you to fight it, I want you to just allow it to happen. Imagine it in your mind, feel it in your body. As that water continues to fill the bucket, that right arm getting heavier and heavier and heavier, being drawn down, down, down. Now I want you to imagine you can see me walking up and I'm tying a string around your left wrist. Attached to the other end of that string are 100 helium balloons. As that bucket continues to get heavier and heavier, I'm going to count backwards from 3 down to 1. When I get to 1, I'm going to snap my fingers. When I snap my fingers, I want you to imagine what it would feel like if those balloons begin to gently lift and rise, pulling your left arm higher and higher into the air. 3, 2, that bucket continues to get heavier and heavier, drawing your right arm closer and closer to the ground. Right arm getting heavier and heavier, left arm lighter, lighter, and lighter. Snap my fingers, it's now like 200. Helium balloons lifting and rising, rising and lifting, gently pulling that left arm higher and higher into the air. That bucket's now pulling your right arm almost straight down by your side. That left arm's almost straight over your head as you now have 300. Helium balloons lifting and rising, rising and lifting, floating higher and higher into the air. Now it's like 500 helium balloons lifting and rising, rising and lifting. That bucket getting heavier and heavier, that left arm getting lighter and lighter. It's always enough weight in your body to hold you in your seat. So that left arm continues to float higher and higher and higher. Just a moment, I'm going to count from 1 up to 3. When I get to 3, I want you to leave your arms stuck right where they are. I want you to open your eyes, look at your arms, and look at the arms of the people around you. Some of you are going to start to realize that something's happening, that something is the beginning of hypnosis. It's on the count of 3. 1, 2, and 3. Eyes open. Pretty weird feeling. Go ahead and relax them down. Relax them down now. Let it go. Shake it out. It's a weird feeling, isn't it? You guys are all doing really good. We're going to move on to step 3. Step 3, deep, deep relaxation. You see, all hypnosis is intense focus and concentration coupled with deep relaxation. I've already asked you to focus only on the sound of my voice. I'm now going to help you relax from the top of your head to the tips of your toes. So once again, everybody focus right here on me. We're going to do those 3 deep breaths again just to help you relax a little more. So taking that first breath in, really filling up your lungs. And exhale all the way out. And the second breath, really filling up your lungs. And exhale again. And again on the third breath, really filling up your lungs. And as you exhale, close your eyes down. Your eyes down, just let them relax. Perfect. As I said, this last stage is just deep, deep relaxation. But I'm going to ask you to use your imagination one more time. I'd like you to imagine a golden light shining on the top of your head. This is the light of relaxation. I'm going to help you move this light from the top of your head to the tips of your toes, relaxing every single muscle, nerve, and fiber in your body. If you follow my instructions perfectly, by the time we're done, you'll be more relaxed than you ever have been in your entire life. So what I'd like you to do right now is just imagine that light moving from the top of your head, down across your forehead, beginning to relax all the muscles in your forehead. Now move that relaxation from your forehead down into the muscles of your eyes. Relaxing all the muscles around your eyes and in your eyelids. Relaxing your eyes so completely, so perfectly, that if I were to ask you to open your eyes, you'd find that it's just too much effort. Your eyes would simply remain closed. Almost as if there's a little dab of super glue underneath each eyelid, helping to hold them closed. I want you to now send that relaxation from your eyes down into your jaw muscles. If your jaw was clenched, just let it unclench now. Allow your teeth to part just a little, feeling that relaxation spreading throughout your entire face. If at any time you feel me touching you on the shoulder, don't let it disturb you in any way. It's just a sign that I like what I'm seeing and I want you to relax even more. So if you feel me come by and touch you on the shoulder, just allow yourself to relax, soften, and go even deeper. Also, if at any time you feel the person sitting next to you leaning on you, it just means that they're relaxed. That gives you permission to relax and let go too. As you now send that relaxation down into your neck, beginning to feel all those muscles in your neck turn loose, limp, and relaxed. Just a moment, I'm going to count backwards from 3 down to 1. When I get to 1, I'm going to snap my fingers. When you hear me snap my fingers, I want you to instantly and automatically relax every single muscle in your neck. Allow your head to fall forward. Allow your chin to come closer to your chest. That's in 3, 2, 1. Relaxing down, letting go. Sinking deeper and deeper relaxed. So that relaxation now moves from your neck down into your shoulders. From shoulder to shoulder, all across your upper back. It's like that relaxation is now becoming contagious. It's flowing freely now down through your arms, past your biceps, down past your triceps, down past your elbows, down into your forearms, down into your wrists, down into your hands, down through your fingers, any and all remaining tension in your upper body flowing freely now down through your arms, out to the tips of your fingers, gone from your mind, gone from your body, gone for good. Said relaxation now spreads throughout your entire back, your upper back, your lower back, wrapping around you like a warm blanket of relaxation, relaxing your chest muscles, relaxing your stomach muscles, allowing you to breathe more freely, allowing you to breathe more easily. Even if you could stand, your legs so relaxed, so tired, drop right back down into your seat, going 10 times deeper relaxed than you were before. Relaxation now moving down into your feet, down into your toes. Any and all remaining tension at all in your body, melting, flowing down through your legs, out through the bottoms of your feet, down into the ground, gone from your mind, gone from your body, gone for good. Now in just a moment I'm going to come by and I'm going to give a little tug on one or both of your arms. When I do, I want you to let that be a signal to relax and go 10 times deeper relaxed than you are right now. When I come by and give a little tug on one or both of your arms, releasing, dropping 10 times deeper relaxed. Nod your heads if you understand. Perfect. You guys are all doing great. Already more relaxed than you have been in a long, long time. But I want to help you relax even more. I'm going to count backwards from 10 down to 1. With each number I say, I want you to double the relaxation that you're currently feeling. So as we go from 10 down to 9, double that relaxation. 9 down to 8, doubling the relaxation in your entire body. 8 down to 7. down to 6, down to 5, halfway there, 5, down to 4, 4, down to 3, 3, down to 2, down to 1. Now there's still one number left, and I want you to imagine you can see that zero floating out in front of you. The other side of zero represents complete and total relaxation. I want you to imagine that zero floating closer and closer to you as you float closer and closer to that zero. I'm going to count backwards from 3 down to 1. When I get to 1, I'll snap my fingers. When you hear me snap my fingers, I want you to imagine passing through that zero to the other side to complete and total relaxation. 3, 2, 1. Starting right now, whenever I say the word sleep or touch you on the forehead, you'll instantly and automatically return to this very pleasant state, always going deeper than the time before. So whenever I say the word sleep or touch you on the forehead, you instantly and automatically return to this very pleasant state, always going deeper than the time before. Also starting right now, my words are your thoughts. These thoughts are your total reality. You believe what I say you believe. You know what I say you know. See what I say you can see. Hear what I say you can hear. Feel what I tell you to feel. Because my words are your thoughts. And these thoughts are your total reality. Nod your head if you accept and understand. Perfect. Also starting right now, any sound you hear other than the sound of my voice, any laughing, any clapping, any cheering, any noise coming from the audience, sends you deeper and deeper into the state of hypnosis. Releasing your inner creativity, allowing you to have more fun. Does any sound you hear other than the sound of my voice only send you deeper and deeper into the state of hypnosis, allowing you to have more fun than you've had in your entire life? Nod your heads if you accept and understand. Perfect. Now, some people who have never seen a hypnosis show before may think you're sound asleep. Let's prove to them you're not sound asleep, that you're just in a state of hypnosis. Everybody take your right hand, hold it high in the air, and give everybody a little wave. Let them know you're still in there. Perfect. And sleep all the way down. Everyone up on stage, you realize this next thing to be true. You're no longer sitting in your high school auditorium. You're not sitting on a beach. It's a beautiful, lovely day. Maybe this is a beach you've always wanted to go to. Maybe it's a beach you've been to before. But it's 85 degrees, the sun's shining down, and you feel wonderful. On the count of 3, you're going to sit up straight in your chair, you're going to kick back, you're going to feel that sun beating down on you. It's going to be a hot one today. It's already up to 87, 88, 89 degrees, and it's just going to keep getting hotter. You're going to want to kick your shoes off, roll your pants up in the shorts, do whatever you got to do to stay cool, as it's now 90 degrees, and it's getting warmer and warmer. On the count of 3, you're going to sit up straight in your chair, eyes tightly closed, just feel that sun beating down on you. 1, 2. And 3, it's 91, 92, 93 degrees, getting so hot. Keep those shoes off, do what you gotta do to stay cool. It's now 95, 96, 97 degrees, it's a beautiful day. Pick yourselves off, do what you gotta do to stay cool. It's now 97, 98, 99, 100 degrees. That temperature just keeps climbing faster and faster. Help each other out. Put a little sunscreen on yourself. You don't want to get a sunburn today. It's your first day of vacation. You don't want to burn, that's for sure. So go ahead, help each other out. Put a little sunscreen on the back of the neck of the person sitting next to you. Help them out. That's right. It's now 105, 106, 107 degrees. It's getting hotter and hotter. 108, 100, 910 degrees. Oh my God, it's getting so hot. Look out on the beach, though. There's a little hottie walking by. Tell that hottie you're checking them out. Say, hey, baby, how you doing? I'm checking you out. That's right. But also look up on the horizon, there's some storm clouds moving in. It's now 112, 115 degrees, but those storm clouds are going to move in. They're going to ruin your day. As the temperature's now starting to dry up, starting to drop as those clouds move in closer and closer. It's already down to 100 degrees, down to 95 degrees. You start to feel some little raindrops in your forehead now. It's really starting to ruin your day. It's down to 90 degrees, and it's getting cooler and cooler. The wind's going to start picking up in just a moment as it's now 80 degrees. Now it's down to 75 degrees. It's getting colder and colder. It's now down to 74, 73. 72 degrees, it's down to 70 degrees, down to 65 degrees, down to 60 degrees, it's getting colder and colder. The person sitting next to you is the only source of heat on this beach. You're gonna wanna huddle up with that person next to you, do what you gotta do to stay warm. It's down to negative 5 degrees, oh my God, it just dropped to negative 5 degrees, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8 degrees, negative 10 degrees, it's getting so cold. That sweat that was forming on your brow is now turning into icicles. It's now negative 20 degrees, negative 25, negative 30 degrees, it's so cold. really wish you hadn't kicked those shoes off now, as it's now negative 45 degrees. So everybody take a deep breath in, and sleep temperature goes back to normal. Everyone up on stage, you realize this is the next thing to be true. You're all members of a world-famous orchestra. You're tonight to put on a show for thousands and thousands of people. Some of you are going to play small instruments like violins, trumpets, or flutes. Some of you are going to play large instruments like drums or pianos. Whatever instrument you choose, you're going to play it better than you've ever played in your entire life. If you don't know how to play an instrument, you better fake it really good. These people paid a lot of money to see this show. You don't want to let them down. So decide in your mind right now what instrument you're going to play. So on the count of three, you're going to sit up straight in your chairs, eyes tightly closed. You're going to grab that instrument and play it better than you ever have in your entire life. All the energy, all the enthusiasm, all the gusto you got. So on the count of three. One, two, and three. Eyes tightly closed. Grab those instruments. Begin to play. That's right. Play it even better. These people are not impressed. These people are hard to impress. I've seen some really world-class orchestras before. More energy. Come on, more energy. All right. I think I know it's going to impress them. Play that instrument behind your back. Play it behind your back. Show them how good you are. That's right. Now, if they're not impressed, play that instrument with your nose. Show them you can do that with your nose. That's right. Violin's rough on your nose, but you gotta impress these people. You're still not impressed. Play that instrument with your butt, your hiney, your fanny, your keister, your derriere, your rear end. There you go. It's always fun to watch the trumpet players play with their butts. There you go. Alright, pick a new instrument, play it the regular way. Pick a new instrument, play it the regular way. That's right. Even more energy, though. Play with more energy. These people are not impressed. I don't even hear any clapping. Right here. Deep breath in. High five, Joe. Sleep, Joe, all the way down. Hi, what's your name? Palma? It's an interesting name. What nationality is that? Deep breath in, Palma. Sleep all the way down. Your name?
Becky.
Becky. Deep breath in. Look right here. Sleep all the way down. And your name?
Dave.
Dave. Thank you for volunteering, Dave. Deep breath in, Dave. Sleep, Dave, all the way. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's hear it for all our volunteers. Person I'm touching right now, you realize this next thing will be true. Next time you open your eyes, you're gonna realize I am the most disgusting person you've ever seen in your entire life. You will not hit me, you will not kick me, you will not spit at me, but you do not want me anywhere near you. I am so foul. I just look like I smell bad. And I dread it, if you understand. Perfect. Not you, dear. Person I'm touching right now, you realize this next thing to be true. Next time you open your eyes, you're gonna realize you're thirstier than you've ever been in your entire life. You just need a drink of water. It's like you just spent a week in the desert without water, and you're getting thirstier, and thirstier, and thirstier. Next time you open your eyes, you're gonna stand up and you're gonna demand I give you a bottle of water. It's not a problem, I got a bottle of water waiting over on the table for you. Problem is, no matter how hard you try, you will not be able to open that bottle, and you're gonna get thirstier, and thirstier, and thirstier. Nod your head if you understand. Perfect. Person I'm touching right now, you realize this next thing could be true. Whenever you see me touch my nose, you're gonna realize that you got a cut someplace on your face and you just need a band-aid. It's not gonna hurt, but you just know you need a band-aid. You see me touch my nose, you're gonna stand up and shout, I need a band-aid. I'll give you a band-aid, you put it on that cut, and you sit right back down as if nothing happened. Next time you see me touch my nose, you need another band-aid, and so on and so on. That's your head if you understand. Perfect. And finally, the person I'm touching right now. Whenever I shake your hand like this, since you are eager for the handshake, whenever I shake your hand like this, you're gonna realize your underwear gets just a little bit tighter. I let go, everything goes back to normal. I shake your hand, it gets even tighter. Not your head, if you understand. Perfect. Everybody up on stage on the count of 3 eyes open. 1, 2, and 3 eyes open. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. I'm sorry, what was your name again?
Mary.
Mary, how you doing? What's the matter?
Nothing.
You sure? What's the matter? I love your hair. It's beautiful. It's a nice sweater, too. Everything okay? What?
Gross.
I'm gross. I'm just trying to do a show. Okay, 1 second. What's the matter?
I'm a little thirsty.
Okay, 1 second, I'll get you the hot water. I always carry extra water. There you go. Perfect. Noah, right? Thank you for volunteering, Noah. That's quite a grip you got there, Noah. Yeah. I think you got confused. It's getting tighter and tighter, trust me, but okay. All right. What? Oh, I can't let go. This is where I've been before. I don't know how to get out of this. Hey, Noah, sleep. What? Oh, 4, 3, 2, 1. What was what? What?
I didn't want to do that.
Sleep all the way down. We'll come back to you in just a minute. What was your name again? What?
Not me again.
Not me again? It's a weird name. Me again? Not me again. So what is it? I'm sorry. What? I got a show to do, so you're going to have to ask someone else to help you. Because I'm trying to... Oh, yeah. Another band-aid? Oh, sorry. There you go. I was carrying extra band-aids. Perfect. Yeah. You see, what Natalie was experiencing is what we call self-limiting beliefs. Any other time she'd be able to open that bottle, but for whatever reason right now, she believes she couldn't open that bottle. A lot of times in life, we have a lot of obstacles we run into. The biggest obstacles we do run into are our own self-limiting beliefs. I had to tell her to ask for help. She didn't even think of it on her own. But now she's so glad she has some help, because that water's so good. What? I'm sorry? Another band-aid. It's going to go through a lot of band-aids, aren't it? It's right under your nose this time I see it. Natalie, how's that water? Me again, not me again. What is your name?
Leave me alone.
Why? I just want to know your name.
You're gross.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to do a show and I just want to know your name.
Mary.
You're married? Or you're married?
Both, actually.
Okay. Bet you by the end of the night you're gonna really, really like me. We'll see. We'll see. I do have to tell you though, Dean and I get to travel around a lot and we get to go to these really cool stores. And in this one store I found this bottle that said Giggle Juice on it. Natalie just drank that whole bottle and I brought it. And she's gonna start laughing like she just heard the funniest joke in the world. She's gonna keep laughing harder and harder and harder. Natalie, why is your boot up? Why you got one boot up? Bet you there's a snort in there someplace too. I know. You can always tell a snorter. Trust me, Mary, by the end of the night, we're gonna be really, really good friends. Natalie, you okay? Check this out. I snap my fingers, it goes away just like. Then it comes back just like. Snap off. Snap on. Natalie, remember, you said we gotta stay in our chairs through the whole show. What are you doing? And it's gone again. Go ahead, grab a seat. Grab a seat. You wanna put your boot in? Yeah, go ahead. Alright. What I got in my pocket? It's a little sleep dust. I'm gonna sprinkle some sleep dust on and they're gonna roll right back down into a deep, deep sleep. Check it out.
Stars silent right behind you. The night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds in the room, the sycamore tree.
Hey, no, I'll wake up. It's okay. I got some dust for you. Keep it clean, it's coming from the neck and above, but you just cannot resist getting your nose in there and getting a big old whiff. It's on the count of three. One, two, and three. Eyes open. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Hurry, take it easy. It's a youngster. Oh, it smells so good. It smells so good. Oh, yeah. It smells so good. Tell you what, it's going to my fingers. You realize it's not coming from the person next to you, it's actually coming from your own body. One, two, and three. Oh, yeah, it's your own body, and it smells even better. Oh, yeah, it smells so, so good. Next time I snap my fingers, though, you realize it's not the best smell in the world, it's actually the most foul, most disgusting smell, and it's still coming from you. One, two, and three. Oh, oh, that is nasty. And it's getting stronger and stronger. Oh, you will not get sick, you will not throw up, but man, that is nasty. And it's gone, it's gone, it's all gone. Everybody take a deep breath in, and sleep all the way down. You're no longer sitting in your high school auditorium. You know, a bunch of the most misbehaved third graders in the world, and I am the meanest teacher you have ever had. Whenever I turn my back, you're gonna make fun of me, stick your tongues out at me, and make faces at me. Do not throw shoes at me, though, because I get really angry if you throw shoes. But whenever I turn my back, you're gonna make fun of me. So don't let me catch you either. If I turn around and catch you, I'm canceling summer vacation, I'm canceling Christmas vacation, you need to be stuck in school forever, and I'm sending notes home to all your parents too. So don't let me catch you. But whenever I turn my back, feel free to make fun of me all you want. On the count of three, one, two, and three. Eyes open, welcome back. We're gonna work on our multiplication tables today. We're working on our threes, so pay attention. Three times one equals three. Three times two equals. Natalie, I told you, you gotta stay in your chair. You too, Mary. I'm telling you. I sent notes home to your parents earlier in the year. I'll do it. Just Pay attention, it's gonna be on the test this week. 3 times 3 equals 9. 3 times. You know, next time I turn my back, I'm still the meanest teacher in the world, but now I got a big hole in my pants and I'm wearing my Santa Claus underwear. Just like. 3 times 5 equals. What is so funny? This kid's not even wearing shoes in class. Neither is she. Her shoes are right in front of her. She's not even wearing her shoes. It's not nice to laugh at people. I'm telling you, I'm sending notes home. Why can't you be more like this guy? This guy's wearing shoes. Why aren't you wearing shoes, Marie? All right. That's right, you are. But now you think you're not. Where's your shoes, Marie? Where are they? Where'd they go?
My shoes back.
What?
My shoes back.
Where are they? No, these are my shoes. These are way too big to be your shoes, Marie. You're just a little third grader. I'm a full-grown adult. See? Doesn't even fit. Alright. Anyway, I don't care if you're in third grade. Now I'm walking funny. I don't care if you're in third grade, it's nap time. I sleep all the way down. Sleep all the way down. Take my shoe back. Everyone up on stage, you realize this next thing will be true. You're now sitting in an IMAX theater with an X-Storytel screen right in front of you, and you're about to watch the funniest movie you have ever seen. On count of three, you're going to sit restricting chairs, eyes open, staring at that 8-story-tall screen, laughing your butts off. Laughing harder than Natalie did drinking that giggle juice because this is the funniest movie you've ever seen. The count of three, sitting restricting chairs, eyes open. 1, 2, and 3, eyes open, watch that movie. This is the funniest movie you have ever seen. And I tap you on the shoulder, it gets 10 times funnier. 10 times funnier. You cannot stop laughing. It's 100 times funnier. 100 times funnier. This is the funniest movie you have ever seen in your entire life. You cannot stop laughing. It's 100 times funnier. 1,000 times funnier. Your sides are gonna hurt. You're laughing so hard. Tell you what though, I'm the type of guy who likes to sneak around in the movie theater and see what else is playing. We're gonna go to the next theater over, and they're playing the saddest, most romantic movie. It's on the count of 3. 1, 2, and 3. This movie gets me every time. Jack! Jack! Stay alive, Jack. Stay alive no matter what, Jack. Rose, you stay alive too, Rose. Jack! Jack, I love you. He's so mad at Rose because there was room for him on that piece of wood. All she had to do was move over. He could have climbed up there. But no, this is the sad part. There he goes to the bottom of the ocean. This makes me cry every time. If you want a Kleenex, I'm getting Kleenex. Raise your hand if you want a Kleenex. This is the saddest movie. I hate Rose every time this movie's. Stupid Rose. So mad at her. Ego. Tell you what, I don't want to watch this bad movie anymore. We're gonna go to the next theater over. Your chairs are glued while they start to take to the floor and they will not move. Because the next movie we're watching is the scariest horror movie in the world and it's in 3D. Your chairs step right to the floor. Bye, Rose. Stupid, selfish woman. We count to 3, 1, 2, and 3. Oh, oh, it's a 3D and it's coming right at you. Oh, look out, Natalie! Oh. You can feel it breathing on your neck, too. He's tapping you on the shoulder. Marie! You, Marie. Everybody take a deep breath in. As you exhale, the scene fades, and you all sleep all the way down. Give these guys a big round of applause. So used to having Dina. Dina's sitting at the back of the room tonight. Because our spinny disc broke, so she didn't have anything to do. She usually hands me my stuff. Everyone up on stage, realize this next thing to be true. We're gonna do a little thing called voodoo. Whatever the monkey does, you do. Because that's the nature of voodoo. On the count of 3, you're gonna sit up straight, your chair's eyes open. 1, 2, and 3, eyes open. Welcome back, welcome back. Why don't you guys stand up right where you are and just look right over here at me. Stand up right where you are. Just gotta put the spell on the monkey. Give me just a second. Elikazam, Elikazoo, this monkey's now voodoo. Let's give it a test. Back to your chairs, back to your chairs. Yeah, just a little bit of that sleepless left. Sleep all the way down. Let's hear it for these guys. Natalie, did you get to hold the snake last year? You want to hold him this year? Come here. No sudden movements, okay? Now, turn around this way. Guess it's before you're here. It's your courage pills. Just swallow those right down. Watch the fear disappear, just like... Pretty cool. See, human beings are born with only two natural fears, the fear of loud noises and the fear of falling from high places. Every other fear you think you have, you've created in your own mind. Control your mind, control your fears, you control your life. It really is that easy. You see, just for a second. Watch this. You're turning back into a belt right in front of your eyes, watch. Give Natalie a big round of applause. Go ahead and have a seat, Natalie. Everybody can have a seat. Back to your chairs. It's my belt. Did that routine end of last school year. I can't even remember where I was, but the guy that was afraid of the belt was not much bigger than me, but you could tell he was a farm guy. He just throws hay bales all day, really strong guy. And the minute I gave him the courage pills and that fear went away, he ripped the head off the snake. It wasn't my belt, it wasn't his belt. He had a buckle in one hand, belt in the other hand, and I had to buy somebody a belt for 20 bucks that night. So sometimes it's safer to just use my own belt and pick a girl. You having fun? Okay. What do I have right here in my pocket? These are little bouncy balls. I sprinkle them with that slip dust. I throw them out, it's gonna hit the back of the auditorium, it's gonna come back and hit each one of you right in the forehead and drop you down into a deep sleep. Just like this. All the way out. Let's hear it for these guys. Got something new that I know none of you saw last year because I just started doing it this year, so. Give me just one second. Somebody up on stage, it's a very special gift. If there's anybody up on stage who feels like they've just got a little extra stress, tension, anxiety in their life, and they'd like to get rid of it right now, just raise your hand in the air. I'm going to pick one of you, and I'm going to help you get rid of it. Yeah, I'll go with Marie because I've tortured her all night. So Marie, you are my volunteer. Everyone up on stage on the count of three, eyes open. One, two, and three, eyes open. Welcome back. Ladies, please have a seat in your chairs. Marie, I'm going to ask you to join me right up here by the table. What I got here, just a Coke bottle, and in this hand I got a little metal chip that I'm going to give to Marie. Just a little teeny metal chip, right, Marie? Okay. Just going to put the bottle in here to see why in just a second. You right-handed or left-handed? Put it in your right hand, because that's your strongest. Go ahead and just put it in your palm, close your fingers around it. If you'd like to stay firm beneath you, as you just close your eyes and sleep standing up, Marie, all the way down. Perfect. Standing up. I've got you. Just standing up. Now, Marie, you told me just a minute ago that you got some extra stress, anxiety, tension, negativity in your life that you'd like to get rid of. Now's the time to make that happen. See, I use that little chip of metal because all of our thought impulses are just electrical impulses. I'm going to ask Marie to send those negative thoughts down through her right arm, down into her hand, into that little metal chip. Just continue to focus and concentrate on all that negativity, all that stress, all that anxiety that you want out of your life. Just send it down your right arm. You may feel that little chip beginning to vibrate. It may start to get warm. But as soon as you're sure all of that negativity is gone from your mind and in that little chip, just give me a little nod and let me know. Perfect. On the count of three, eyes open. One, two, and three, eyes open. Welcome back, Marie. Let me see that little chip. Why don't you just watch this bottle? This is what happens when you allow negativity and stress to build up in your body, okay? So promise me after you see this, you'll never allow it to build up again. You find healthy, constructive ways to release it, okay? Because this is what happens to your body when you hold negativity in. You feel better having let it go now?
Perfect.
I know. It's a big load off your body, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead and have a seat. Let's hear it from Marie. Give her a big round of applause. Nicholas, for all of you too. Don't keep that negative stress in your body. Let it go. Look at how much better she feels now. She just feels drained. Feels amazing. Perfect. Everybody take a deep breath in and sleep all the way down. Person I'm touching right now, only the person I'm touching right now, you realize this next thing to be true. Next time you open your eyes, you're going to realize I am standing next to the most beautiful woman in the world. She's got long, flowing hair. Bit of gray, she's a little bit of a cougar, but she is the hottest woman you have ever seen in your life. The minute you open your eyes, you're going to hear music. You're going to light eyes on this beautiful woman standing next to me, and you just need to dance with her. Nod your head if you understand. Perfect. We're going up on stage on the count of three, eyes open. One, two, and three, eyes open.
When your legs don't work like they used to before.
She's been standing backstage just checking you out all night. She is so in love. Go ahead, show her your moves, man. Impress her. Come on, move those hips a little bit. There you go. Now you're getting into it. Oh, yeah. just a moment, he's going to go in for a big dip and a kiss, and he's going to realize exactly what he's doing.
Baby, my
heart. 1 week. As soon as he sits down, he's going to fall in love again, though. Watch. Come on, man. Show her your moves. Get your number for you. She'll be waiting for you backstage. Wanna blow her a kiss? What I got right here is a little sleep boomerang. I'm gonna throw it out. It's gonna go around that wall, around the back of the room, come down this wall, hit each one of you right in the forehead, drop you right back down and do a deep, deep sleep. All except for Marie. Marie, it's gonna miss her and go right down and hit everybody else. Just like this. So Marie, you still think I'm the most disgusting person in the world? Yeah. You sure about that? You sure? You snap my fingers, you suddenly realize I am the sexiest man you've ever seen. Just like... How you doing? What's that? Been checking me out all night, haven't you? Yeah? Sleep, Maria. Thought you should love me by the end of the night. If only I'd had those skills when I was in high school. I didn't think very much in high school. I wish I could have done this. That would have been so awesome. That is the end of our show. Let's give our volunteers one more big round of applause. Although, just so I make sure I'm not in the doghouse, I did marry a very beautiful woman, so it was worth the wait. Trust me. This is the end of the show where I'm going to give these volunteers the positive suggestions that I promised them. So everyone up on stage, if there's anything in your life that you'd like to change, now's the time to make that happen. I want you to create an image in your mind of a future you having been completely successful at making whatever change it is you'd like to make. Make this image as big, bold, and bright as possible. If there's any sound associated with this image, I want you to turn the volume up now. Make it crystal clear. I want you to notice every single detail about this image. Notice your posture. Notice the smile on your face. Notice how proud you are of yourself for having made this change that you'd like to make. So we see tonight, the subconscious part of the mind is a very playful part of the mind. It's also the part of the mind where a powerful change can happen. All they need to do is ask their subconscious mind to make this image a reality, and it'll go to work and make it happen for them. So I'd like everyone to do that now. Ask your subconscious mind to make this image a reality. Everything we have in life started out as an idea, an image in someone's mind. They put some action behind this image and made this image a reality. It's what you need to do now. Put some action behind this thought. Without action, it's always just a dream. Put some action behind this thought and make it a reality. You're in charge of your own lives. Your futures are in your hands. You control your own destinies. Make wise choices. Make choices that benefit you and benefit the people around you. Just continue to focus and concentrate on that image. Asking your subconscious mind to make it a reality while I talk to the audience. I want to thank you guys one more time for coming out here tonight. Let's give our volunteers one more big round of applause. Some of you may have seen on the way in that we've got a table set up. I started out as a clinical hypnotist, helping people lose weight, quit smoking. This was a lot more fun, so I closed my office, created a CD line to help people out. So if anybody's interested in buying a CD, those are for sale up front. There's also DVDs. I've been recording the whole show. If anybody's interested in buying a DVD of the show, they make excellent but they make excellent presents for people. If they can't remember what happened, it makes great blackmail material. So if you're interested, please see Dina after the show. She'll fill out a form. You can buy a DVD. Also, I just published my own book. It just came out a couple months ago, so there's a book out on the table. I wrote that. It's about creating personal change in your life. It's just really a blueprint for making change. So if there's anything in your life that you want to do, if you want to run a marathon, it'll tell you what you need to do to make that change happen in your life. So it's about 100 pages. It's a little read, something you can read in an afternoon and start implementing everything I put in there. So if you're interested, please see Dina. That's for sale up front also. Everyone up on stage, just a moment. I'm going to count from 1 to 5. When I get to 5, sit up straight in your chairs, eyes open, wide awake, fully refreshed, awake, alive, alert, feeling awesome. Starting with the number one, still completely relaxed. Number two, beginning to orient to the room around you, becoming aware of the other sounds and the other people. The number three, taking a nice deep breath in, filling up your lungs with clean, fresh oxygen. And the number four, your eyes beneath the lids feeling as if they've been bathed in a cool mountain spring. And on five, eyes open, wide awake, fully refreshed, awake, alive, and alert. All of this applause is for you. And you end up on the floor right now. I do want to thank you guys for volunteering. You can return to the audience now. Once again, my name is Jack Hirsch. Thank you and enjoy the rest of your evening. Have a great Halloween too. Everybody stay safe out there.